system of equations. We know how to handle this. We can knock this off with substitution, elimination, but check this out. I got a really clever way to go after this with substitution. See this, like if you start off doing substitution, you'd solve this for x, right? You'd divide both sides by 2, you'd have fractions. But check out this clever little gimmick I came up with. See that 4x? I'm going to think of that as 2 times 2x. So I'm going to think of this second equation right here as 2 times 2x plus 3y equals 3 minus 23y. There's my 2x. I can substitute for 2x instead of substituting for x. You don't just only have to substitute just for variables. I can substitute for 2x just like I substitute for x. I've got an expression here for 2x. I'll go ahead and substitute. And I have 2 times 4 minus 13y, because that's what 2x is, plus 3y equals 3 minus 23y. All right, so now let's go ahead and multiply this out. 2 times 4 is 8. 2 times minus 13y is negative 26y plus 3y equals 3 minus 23y. All right, let's clean all this up. I'm going to bring all the y's over to this side. Let's see, I have minus 26y plus, actually, let's just simplify this first. 8 minus 23y equals 3 minus 23y. So I'll bring the y's over here, put the constants over there. I'll subtract 8 from both sides. 3 minus 8 is negative 5. I'll add 23y to both sides, and I'll get 23y minus 23y is just 0. 0 is not negative 5. What happened? All right. Enough of substitution. Let's try elimination. I thought that was a really clever trick, though. All right, let's try elimination instead. Maybe that system, this system just doesn't work with substitution. That doesn't make any sense. All right, first step, get organized. All right, we'll bring all the variables over to this side. We'll have 2x plus 13y equals 4. I'm going to add 23y to both sides. I'll have 4x plus 26y equals 3. Now I want to set up an elimination. I'll go ahead and eliminate x. I'm going to multiply both sides of this equation by negative 2. That'll let me set up my elimination here. If I multiply this, the left side, by negative 2, I'll have minus 4x minus 26y is minus 8. So I got my elimination set up. I'll knock out the x's when I add these two equations. 4x minus 4x, well, it's 0. The x's are gone. 26y minus, so are the y's. The y's are gone too. 26y minus 26y, gone. So we get 0 and 3 minus 8. Negative 5. 0 still isn't negative 5. I mean, it wasn't negative 5 back here. It's not negative 5 here. 0 is not negative 5. What's going on? I'm so confused. All right. Let's try this again. All right. Get organized first. Add 13y to both sides. We had 2x plus 13y equals 4. Add the 23y to both sides here. 4x plus 26y, 3. So look at what happens when I multiply both sides of this equation by 2. 4x plus 26y equals 8. Just multiply both sides of this equation by 2. So this equation I can rewrite like this. This equation I can rewrite like this. It's impossible for 4x plus 26y to be both 8 and 3. They can't be both values. It has to be, you know, you can only have one value for 4x plus 26y. And once you pick x and y, you just get one thing, whatever it comes out. You can't get 8 and 3. It's impossible to find a value, values of x and y that satisfy both of these equations, because 8 and 3 are not the same. Just like 0 and negative 5 are not the same. And this 0 and negative 5 are not the same either. You know, this clever substitution was perfectly valid. This is a great, clever way to go after problems. We got to the 0 equals minus 5 thing here, just like we did here. This elimination, perfectly valid, and this explains what's going on right here. We can rewrite these two equations as these two equations let me grab my pen, right here. And these two equations can't ever possibly both be true, because 4x plus 26y can't be both 8 and 3. The values of x and y that satisfy these equations, there are none. There are no solutions. And some people might call this system of equations inconsistent. That's a word they would use. I just said there are no solutions to this system of equations. There's no way to satisfy both of them. So if you're plugging away at a system of equations, you do a clever substitution, and you come down to an equation like this that can never, ever be true. This can't ever possibly be true. Then, well, your conclusion is there are no solutions to your system of equations. Now, you should go back and check your work. Make sure you didn't make a little mistake somewhere. We did that by setting up an elimination. We did this problem two different ways. We came up with the same result. There are no solutions to this system of equations. Now, to make sure we have that down, try one more problem. For what values of C, that's C right in there, but there are no values of P and Q that satisfy this system. So we want to figure out what C has to be in order for this system of equations to have no solutions. Now, if we look back and say what we did here, well, we set up an elimination, and the elimination knocked out both variables. And that led us into some trouble here and made it clear that there are no solutions to this system. Let's try doing the same thing here. We'll set up an elimination. Now, the easiest thing will be to multiply this equation, both sides of this equation by 3, and both sides of this equation by 2. And that'll let us set up an elimination of Q. So we'll take the first one, the first equation first. We'll multiply both sides by 3, and we'll get 9CP minus 24Q equals 27. We'll multiply both sides of the second equation by 2. We'll get 10P plus 24Q equals 28. Now, when we add these two equations over here on the left, the Q's do indeed cancel out just as planned. Minus 24Q plus 24Q, gone. And then we have 9CP plus 10P. And over on the right, we have 55. Now, here we can factor out the P. Now, if this were just 9P plus 10P, you'd have 9 plus 10P. Well, here we have 9C plus 10. That whole thing times P is 55. Now, the question is, when are there no solutions? When is there no value of P that's going to satisfy this? Now, if this comes out to be anything besides 0, we can solve for P. You know, if this comes out to be 1, then we've got P equals 55. We can substitute back up here, get Q. But if this comes out to be 0, then there's no solution for P, because if this comes out to be 0, we have 0 equals 55. 0 is not 55, so there are no solutions. So what we want for our values of C, such that this system has no solutions, we need 9C plus 10 to be 0. Solving that equation, of course, subtract 10 from both sides, then divide by 9, we get C equals negative 10 ninths. Now, if you want to check that, take that negative 10 ninths, stick it back into this equation, and then try solving the resulting system of equations. You should find that there are no solutions. And then you'll know for sure that we are done.